White, and I'm the principal here at Ashland Middle School. I'd like to take this time to welcome back our students from last year who attended Ashland Middle School, but I specifically and especially want to welcome any new student, as well as our students that are coming to us from Taft, our incoming sixth graders. So with that being said, welcome. In order for us to have a successful school year, we follow the mission statement of educating, empower, and energizing our students to engage in their individual excellence. We also follow three simple R's each and every day that we're here. That's being ready, responsible, and respectful. Whether it be in the cafeteria, whether it be in a classroom, whether it be in transition, we've asked our students to make sure they were following the simple three R's of being ready, responsible, and respectful in all areas of our building. If our students do that, we will have a successful school year.
Hi, I am Mr. Keller. I am one of the assistant principals here at the middle school. I am still one of the assistants over at Taft as well. Part of my job here today here at the middle school is to help introduce you to how the middle school is set up. So why don't you come with me on this virtual tour to see how the middle school is laid out for you this coming school year. Come on.
If you were to come in through the main doors, you would first see these two ladies sitting here. Here is Mrs. Carey and Mrs. Boland. They're both secretaries. Those of you who know Mrs. Spicer and Mrs. Anderson from Taft, these ladies perform the same job. So if you come late to school, you will report directly to these two for a pass. If you have to leave early, like you did at Taft, you have to bring your note down to these ladies first thing in the morning. Then when it's time to leave, you will report back to Mrs. Carey and Mrs. Boland to wait for your ride.
To the left of these ladies is where our guidance department is located. We have three counselors, Mrs. Hodep, Mrs. Packard, and Mrs. Howman. If you wish to see any of them for any of your needs, come down before school, during lunch, or after school and sign up on these sign-up sheets, and they will call you down when your time comes.
If you are sick, we have another location for you. It is the clinic, which is located right next door to the main office. As you can see here by this entrance, that it is located just off the cafeteria next to the main office, and you'll go in this door. This is where you'll go if you're a student who takes medicine during the school day, or if you are become ill and have to go see the nurse. She will be here to help you out. Now we are back in the center of the building, the cafeteria. Here is where we serve lunches for all students. You will come down here with the entire grade level to have your lunch. Some lunches will be bagged that you'll be bringing from home, and others will be purchased here at school. Here you'll be asked to sit and eat your lunches. There is no recess scheduled here at the middle school. The library is located off the cafeteria. We don't have a scheduled library time, but it is open for students during lunch when you first arrive to school. The gym is also located off of the cafeteria. It is in this room that you will have your gym classes. Oftentimes, gym will be taken to the stadium and handled on an outside basis. There's also some potential we may have gym classes heading over to the field house. Right next door to our gymnasium is our fitness room. Our music classrooms are also located near the cafeteria. Whether you sign up for band, orchestra, or choir, those will be located in that area. If you signed up for general music, your classroom is pretty close to these, just a little bit further down the hallway. The art classrooms are located right next to the music room, right down this hallway. At some point in your schedule, you will see a class that is either labeled keyboarding, computer class, or health class. The room numbers are 015, 115, or 215. Each of those rooms are the exact same location stacked on top of one another here. One is on the 8th grade floor, the 015. One is on the 7th grade floor, the 115. And one is on the 6th grade floor, the 215. Just be aware where that is located. It is around the corner from where the elevator is located.
So what you want to remember is that the building is divided into two sections.
This section I'm walking from here is the encore section or the special section. That's where the cafeteria is, the main office is there, the clinic is there, the gym is there. All those sorts of things are located over in this part of the building. In this section of the building is the academic wings. And they are on three different floors. So the first floor is the eighth grade, second floor is seventh grade, and the third floor is the sixth grade where you will spend most of your time. Right now we are in what's called the extended learning area, otherwise known as the ELA area. You'll notice here in the middle of the room are lockers. All students will have a locker in the middle of their ELA area. As you notice, there are some lockers are lower and some lockers are higher, and if there's a need to switch, just let a staff member know and we will take care of it. In terms of locker usage this school year, it will be limited. No students will use lockers for the first few weeks of the school year. When the time comes to start using lockers, there will be specific training we will provide for students who are not used to using lockers. Off this main room are all the 10 classrooms that you would ever need in dealing with your core academic subjects, which means your math classes, your social studies, your science, and your ELA classes. All of them are located off of this main room.
I hope you found this video very informative and helpful. If you have any questions at any time, please do not hesitate to contact the main office at 419-289-7966. We will certainly answer any questions or concerns you might have. Hope you have a great school year, and go Aeros.